When you are negotiating an agreement with the IRS, you want to reduce your tax bill or get the lowest payment that you can. Sometimes you need to be a little creative, yet realistic, in accounting for allowable living expenses. Hi, I'm Gary, and welcome to Tax Bulldog for the best thoughts and ideas for trimming your tax debt. Now, these videos are to help you to help yourself to avoid costly professional fees. If your situation has a level of complexity, then you may want to consult a tax professional. But before I start, I have to make a few disclosures, which are listed in the description below, so please review those. So to get down to this subject, in this short video, I'm going to talk about getting the most out of allowable living expenses when negotiating with the IRS. As you may be aware, the IRS limits living expenses to their allowable living standards, which taxpayers can claim for determining their ability to make payments to the IRS. Now, the IRS sets these standards to assure taxpayers can reasonably pay their tax debt, not let unnecessary or lavish expenses deter that. Some of these living expenses can be reallocated to employee business expenses or self-employed business expenses. Some of these examples are utility and telephone expenses. These are expenses often claimed for the home office deduction on a tax return. For those who work from their home or run their business out of their home, they should reasonably allocate part of the household expenses to offset their business income. Otherwise, income may be inflated and expenses underreported. That would happen if an expense relative to business was not taken into account, and conversely, a relative expense is not allowed in the financial analysis. These are costs of producing that income. That will reduce overall net income and get an allowable expense for an item that may otherwise be capped by the standards. It is probably reasonable to allocate expenses based on the previous year's home office deduction percentage. For cell phone expenses, one may use a higher percentage based on the actual usage as determined by the business owner's records. Carrying this thought a little bit further, we should be able to make an allowance for professional fees when business taxes are involved or personal taxes as a result of business or other income-producing activity. We may need to carefully make an allocation based on the type of activity. If a tax debt is being resolved and getting the taxpayer on track with compliance, we need to make some allowance for the professional fees. The same as for any tax preparation. That part of tax preparation that is related to business forms is a deductible expense on tax returns. So too it is with professional tax fees. The tax professional fees for tax preparation and tax advice are tax deductible for non-business clients if the client can itemize his or her deductions. It goes in the miscellaneous category subject to the 2% exclusion on Schedule A. In some cases, professional fees may be what enables a client to be able to itemize deductions and gain other deductions otherwise not allowed. Now, despite maybe not being able to deduct on a tax return, it should still be considered expense in the financial analysis for determining ability to pay. So as a recap, take a close look at expenses to see what can be allocated to business to give a truer picture of the taxpayer's financial analysis to get a correct resolution of the case. Not all of these will work in every case. It depends on the strength of the expenses and the merits of the case. Now here are some resources, and I'll put these in the description below. TaxBulldog.com. This is my website with many articles, documents, forms, and other information in regards to dealing with tax collection and audit issues. I try to demystify things. /IRS Back Taxes book. This is a book that I wrote with my co-author, and it's available online at this link. Tax Bulldog here on YouTube for helpful videos. So in closing, thank you for watching this video. If you liked it and you got some useful information and ideas from it, please give me a like and share it with your family, friends, and colleagues. This is all I do, and I do it well. Please subscribe to see my future videos as I produce them, so you can be aware of topics that may be timely and important to you at that time. And be sure to hit that bell icon so you will not miss out on any new information. Please leave your comments below. I can answer general questions here. For specifics, please contact me at taxbulldog.com. Thank you.